On Christ the silent rock I stand, all of the ground is sinking sand. So stomp your feet and clap your hands, our feet are on the rock.
Hey, how's it going, Rock Church? This is Brother Javi coming to you with the Stay Connected series. And I just wanted to talk about balance. And we'll kind of define what balance is as I start to read. In Job 31:6, it says, let me be magnified in a just balance, that God may know my integrity. Proverbs 16:11, a just weight and balance are the Lord's. All the weights in the bag are his work. It says, the Proverbs tells us that all things are God's, and that he is and must always be the standard of which we measure everything. He and his character are true balance. And Proverbs 11:1, it says, a false balance is an abomination to the Lord, but a just weight is his delight. As God expects scales and balances to be used with fairness and equity, so too is his way of life. So I broke these down into three examples of life. And balances of life are these. And number one, it says true balance. In Micah 6:9, it says, he has told you, O man, what is good and what does the Lord require of you, but to do justice and to love kindness and to walk humbly with your God. I know that's a hymn, an old hymn that we sing at church, but I thought it was a very good verse. It says to be fair in all the dealings and whatever situation you are in, just as a scale tries to be equally balanced, so you also must balance the fairness of your circumstance. And you know, in life, there's, you know, I have at work, we have a lot of situations where we try to be fair. As a supervisor, I try to be fair with how I distribute work, or even how my work is being distributed. I have to understand. I have to be my own just person and let myself know. It's like, hey, I need to go get this task done. I need to go do this work. I can't rely on everybody doing some of my responsibilities or just pondering off to other people. But I have to keep myself in check and making sure that I do my fair share too. And it says, and number two, righteousness. It is defined in the Bible, a state of having a right relationship with God, other people, and the creation. Also, having a way what is just, honest, and faithful to God's teachings. Just as the standard of righteousness, to be righteous is to be right with God. The righteousness of Christ is inputted in us when we are saved. It is something we are called to pursue in living a righteous life. Today actually was pretty cool that one of my coaches, he gave an example of Cain and Abel, and Cain didn't give the righteous sacrifice, and Abel did. And for that, his brother disliked him. He felt like God didn't accept his sacrifice, and his brother, out of jealousy or rage, killed Abel. And Abel brought forth that righteous sacrifice to the Lord, and it was acceptable and pleasing to him. But Cain, out of his anger, you know, killed his brother. So living a righteous life is not easy. We're always tempted. We're always pulled by this world to live in another lifestyle, to live by their way of standards. But we know that God in Christ is our standard, and it's not easy. But we try our best. And number three, it says godliness. A lifestyle of living that reflects the character of God and is characterized by the belief in God, reverence of God's laws, and obedience to God. In 2 Timothy, let me read this real quick. In 2 Timothy 3, verses 12 through 17, it says, yes, all who desire to live godly in Christ Jesus will suffer persecution. But evil men and imposters will grow worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. But you must continue in the things which you have learned and been assured of, knowing from whom you have learned them, and that from childhood you have known the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make you wise for salvation through faith, which is in Christ Jesus. It says, all Scripture is given by inspiration and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, instruction, righteousness. And the man of God may be complete, thoroughly equipped for every good work. And living in godliness is like I said, in righteousness. We're constantly being pulled. This is the verse that we that came to mind. It says, "A little leaven leavens a whole lump." Sometimes we're persuaded, and not maybe by our own flesh. Sometimes our flesh tries to take shortcuts in life, to do things the easiest way, and maybe as they say, kind of put the dust underneath the carpet and let it, try to hide it, and knowing that, later is just going to be found. And sometimes that's the way our flesh is. Our flesh wants to hide things, to do things the easy way. But we have a higher standard. It says it's difficult to live life for the Lord, living God's standard, but trying to live God's standards is rewarding. Knowing that you have that communication with the Lord, when you're trying, you're saying, Lord, help me with this struggle. Help me with this situation, where you're inviting God into your life, into your problems, into your struggles, so that he can give you strength. He can give you pleasure, and he can give you reward. And it's rewarding knowing that you have God beside you, and you are asking him and trying to live for him day by day. So there's a little story. I remember hearing this a long time ago, and I think it was from Brother Smiley, Ray Apodaca's brother. And I was he shared this story, and I really enjoyed it, and I really took it. Kind of sometimes when I think about it, it brings to mind and how to try to live our lives for the Lord. And it's not simple. It says, so this little girl, she goes to her dad, and she asks her dad, father, is it difficult to go one day without sinning? And he goes, one day, it might be a little difficult. So she starts bringing it out. Well, she goes, what about 30 minutes? He goes, well, maybe in 30 minutes you may do something wrong or displeasing to the Lord. And she goes down to 1 minute, and he goes, and he starts to see where she's going with this. And he goes, yeah, you know what? Maybe you can go 1 minute, without sinning and without, displeasing the Lord. And she goes, okay. She goes, then that's how I'm going to live my life. I'm going to live my life 1 minute at a time, trying to please the Lord. And, I know it's a simple story. There's a lot of simplicity in it, but it's a way of seeing how can I live my life pleasing the Lord? If it's 1 minute at a time, minute by minute, then we do that. But we do it trying. We do it pleasing God. We do it knowing that we are doing it for the Lord. Lots of times we say that that our company or our bosses are not our boss, but that we have one boss who looks upon us, and that we try to do our best for that one that has called us into this life to live for him. This is where we're considered, we're called lights of this world, and we track a lot of attention. And even as you look at a light in darkness, you see a lot of gnats and a lot of bugs all surrounded that light, and that's, sometimes that's what the enemy tries to do. It tries to dim our light or bug us and pick at us, but we're doing our best to live for the Lord, and we want to be a light for him, and we enjoy being a part of his kingdom and trying to bring others to him. And I do believe that, there is reward when we try to live for the Lord. So our life's balance, it's a standard of life. It's a life that, we are called into, a life to pursue, And you know, just as living for the Lord, being a witness for the Lord, I want to try to do my best to live a godly life, to live a righteous life, to be godly and be weighed, as those balances would say, to be weighed in those balances to do what is right, not be one-sided, doing what is wrong or trying to do what is good. I don't want people to think that I'm self-righteous in any way, but I want people to see that I'm living for the Lord and I want to live for the Lord. And I just pray and I encourage that, that you two brethren, we're in this life together and, we live in this world, and, let us not be persuaded by this world, but let us continue loving and serving the Lord and being a light for him. And I thank you, brethren, for listening to me and hearing me. And Lord bless you. Take care. When I feel my hope about to break.